who choose abortion for their own reasons.
Gold medal winning Olympic fencer Lee Kiefer says bodily integrity and decisional autonomy to their individual careers and women's sports in general are important. The Supreme Court will hear arguments on the law in December. The Republican-sponsored audit of the 2020 election in Arizona's most populous county shows President Biden beat former President Trump. It's the same as official results and recount showed last year. Arizona Secretary of State Katie Hobbs says the results come as no surprise.
This whole thing has just been a sham. We knew that, and nobody should take it seriously.
The company conducting the hand recount of more than 2 million ballots in Maricopa County actually says Trump lost by a wider margin than the county's official election results. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy checking back in on a crash on the 605.
Southbound side just before Florence and Norwalk. I just received really good news about this crash. It was stuck in a carpool and left lane. A motorcycle crash has now been cleared from the roadway entirely, but it's still a struggle from Washington. Now look at things in Sherman Oaks, southbound side of the 405, just before Sepulveda Boulevard. A crash reported stuck in the center lane. It's an overall slow ride from the 101. KFI in the sky helps you either faster. I'm Florence Crump.
Southland weather from KFI. Tonight the clouds return. Lows will be in the 50s to around 60 throughout Southern California. We leave local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Andrew Carabella.
This report is sponsored by Norm Reed's Honda Superstore. Summer may be almost over, but there's still time to get super prices on a super selection of new Hondas. During the final days of the Honda Summer Sales Event, return your Honda lease to one of their 5 lease return super centers and upgrade today. Online at normreeds.com.
Trains often appear further away and moving more slowly than they really are. And they can't stop quickly. Even if the engineer hits the brakes right away, the result is disaster. Stop. Trains can't. Paid for by NHTSA.
The physicians at Memorial Care Miller Children's and Women's Hospital Long Beach train longer, so your child's recovery is quicker. Every child is unique, and so is their care, which is why Miller Children's and Women's recruits only the best pediatric specialists. Learn more at millerchildrens.org/elite.
President said he can't wait for his booster. What is that about? Come on, he's waiting for it? You think the president says, I want a booster, and they're lining up 200, booster givers. I don't want to do it to him. No, I'm going to do it.
Bill Handel, morning from 6 to 10.
Surprise, President. He raids your fridge.
Yeah, brother.
Borrows your car without asking.
Tragic? What's that?
He's your brother-in-law.
I'll pay you back.
He takes what's yours, and there's nothing you can do. But when identity thieves want to take what's yours, you can do something. LifeLock by Norton monitors your info and alerts you to potential threats. If you become a victim, they can help fix it. No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses. But you can save up to 25% off your first year at LifeLock.com using promo code NEW.
KFI AM 640.
Digital photography on the Jet Guy Show with Chris Markwart. He's my personal photo sensei at sensei.photo, sensei.photo. Hello, Chris. How are you today?
I'm doing wonderful. How are you?
I'm great. I didn't realize I was talking earlier about a messy assignment. I didn't realize it was time for a review.
High time. We skipped the week and should have been after, but it's now. So, yeah, the messy assignment has been going on for a bit of a month. We have 50 results, and it's time to take a look at the photos. And I have them here. I've chosen 3 photos to talk about here.
I do have to say, even the messy photos are beautiful.
That was kind of the idea, to take beautiful photos of messy stuff.
Beautiful.
And all the listeners who participated have delivered. That's really good stuff. It was a tough choice this time. So, I made a choice. First one I've chosen is called Kitty Playground. So, what we're looking at is someone's kitchen floor.
Uh-huh.
With open boxes. It's quite
with my sea life.
With boxes, cardboard boxes, and several of them, and a bag, and a hat, a black hat, which I guess, yeah, probably kept like boxes. So there's one main reason. Well, first of all, it's a nice, messy photo. Second, it's taken with an iPhone, so again, a proof that you can take a great photo with just the thing that you have in your pocket. But there's an interesting thing to observe here, and that is, do you see this mist? In the top half.
Yes, there's a lot of light coming in from the window, and it's all misty.
Right. Well, and the interesting thing is that I'm pretty sure the kitchen isn't misty, but that's one of the artifacts that you sometimes get from lenses, where light coming from the front will reflect back and forth inside the lens. You know, there's several layers of lens and glass in there, so that the light can reflect on. And that sometimes, especially with very bright light coming from the front, there's in here, can create that. So, some lenses are kind of immune, but those are really, really expensive ones. I kind of like this effect. I think it's interesting light phenomenon that we're looking at here. So anyway, that's the first one. Second one is a photo taken by our moderator. So we're looking top down. She shot that top down picture of her feet. Blue shoes, orange socks, and a puddle of sorts, and fall leaves of different colors in the water, which is kind of messy, but then on the other hand, I like the fact that the orange and the socks repeats into leaves, and it's a nice contrasting color to the blue shoes, so it's nice to get the nice. I think I like the color scheme in that, so.
And the mess here is the autumn leaves that have filled the puddle.
Probably, but it doesn't feel too messy. It's a little messy. And then, last but not least, last photo is by R. Frazier, who has been featured on here several times before. By the way, I don't look at the names when I choose the photos. I only look at the photos. I just realized it was Renee's photo, so. Same with our Frazier. This is an industrial type of situation. We're looking at, some industrial machinery, lots of tubing and grayish wood color, and I like the mint character or something. Sort of conveyor belt and then stuff. So it looks messy, but on the other hand, those things are notoriously difficult to photograph because you have a messy background that takes away from the subject, or there's too much in the photo because you can't see far away, you have to be close, and then you use a wide angle that catches more stuff in the photo that you want. And this photo has been taken with a telephoto lens from far away, and the background is just low contrast, landscape, side of a hill kind of thing. It's a messy situation, but it feels really well tidied up in terms of a photograph. So that's pretty much what I was looking for. Tidy photos of messy things. So really good job, everyone. So beautiful. Yeah. That's great. 50 photos in the collection we have here, and wasn't easy. Definitely not easy. So. Good job.
Now, we need a new assignment. We have to start all over.
We need a new assignment, right? And I don't have one. But we'll make one. So, here's the thing. Remember a few weeks ago, we talked about photo assignments, like photo exercises. Mm-hmm. And then the last one that I brought, I would get a fishbowl, put some words in there on pieces of paper. And then I thought, that would be a good idea to give you to it. So, this is what I've done. Here is the official
fishbowl.
You got a fishbowl? I got a fishbowl, and I'm not afraid to use it. I put adjectives in there, like stuff like adventurous, or busy, or colorful, or mysterious, that's all that kind of stuff. So, let's come with adjectives, and we'll do a drawing. I will draw one right here. It's exciting. It's so exciting. It is. The assignment is, here we go, happy. Well, that's a good assignment for
Yeah.
Happy.
I think so.
All right. So, picture that illustrates the word, the concept, the idea. Happy. Right.
What? Once you get that, we'll do this with all the other assignments from now on.
I like that.
Bowl.
I like that. So, once you get, the idea of what you're looking for, go out there. The whole point of it, really, there's no prize. The idea is to get out there and take more pictures. Anything that gets you to take more pictures is a good thing because the more pictures you take, the better your pictures will be. Nobody ever got better not using their camera. Let's put it that way. It doesn't matter if you have a fancy camera phone, just fine if you got the new iPhone. Maybe play with that a little bit. Get an old iPhone, do that. Doesn't matter. Go out and take a picture that illustrates the word, the concept, the idea of happy. Now, once you've got something, you can submit up to one a week, okay? You're going to submit it to the tech guy group on Flickr. That's where Renee Silverman is our moderator. The tech, so flickr.com, that's free, photos and stuff. And you join the tech guy group, also free. You'll know you're in the right place. There's 11,000 members. It's a very active group. Renee, the moderator, will welcome you into the group and then submit your happy picture. But do us a favor so we know that it's a submission for next month's review. Tag it, and not just happy, tag it TG happy. TG being tech guy, that way we'll know it's for the tech guy show, and Chris is going to be looking at those. Happy should be a lot of submissions. You got a lot of messages. How do they sound? Yeah, messy messages are really good, and happy I think will be even more. A lot of messy pets. Seems like pets and children were the prime source of messy. messy photos. I wonder why. They may also be the prime choice for happy. They go together. Messy and happy. Yeah. Again, check out group on Flickr. Happy. Now, if you're interested in Chris Marquardt, he's interested in you. He does coaching. He has classes. The best place to start is sensei.com. That's his website for coaching, sensei.photo. But Chris is also a great photographer in his own right and hosts one of the best photography podcasts out there. Certainly the longest running, Hit from the Top Floor. Is this back when you used to be in the top? You're not in the top floor anymore, are you? Well, the house has a top floor. PFTTF.com. And sometime soon we'll be doing those photo workshops again. I can't wait. Let us know in the next minute. I want to be on. Thank you, Chris Michael. Thank you. More of your calls still to come. We all report the tech guy. Happy. Take happy pictures. Happy to see you. You're listening to KFI AM 640. We keep it right here for more tech.
All right, thank you.
I'm Andrew Karen. KFI 24-hour newsroom. U.S. Representative Karen Bass has been expected to announce her candidacy for mayor of L.A. Kelly County is reporting over 1,600 new coronavirus cases and 29 deaths. And a high school student in Maryland has been facing weapon charges after he had a ghost gun in his backpack. Right now, let's get to traffic. Looks like a crash on the 101.
Southbound side just before Vermont in Hollywood, as the crash is stuck in the center lane. Your right flows to a crawl from Hollywood Boulevard. In West LA, crash has cleared southbound 405 just before Sepulveda. It's along the right shoulder, but it's going overall. Go right from the 101. Terrifying if that helps get you there faster. Keep going from.
Want a new set of wheels without spending hours at car dealerships? Download the Roto app. That's R-O-D-O. You can grab thousands of vehicles from your phone, buy a car in minutes, and even have it delivered. Plus, Roto finds every good car available, so you know you're always getting the best price. With no hidden fees. Listen, if you're ready to buy a car, make it easy on yourself and go with Roto. Download the Roto app now or check out Roto.com. That's ROTO.com.
Prescription products require an online consultation. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information.
My husband's eating with a cup of marriage. was our answer. Terry connected my husband with a licensed provider online who got medication to treat his ED at a fraction of the price of the name brand delivered right to our door. Thanks, we got our intimacy and our marriage back.
Right now, get your first online provider visit free when you go to forehands.com/joy. forehands.com/joy. We're recruiting for a clinical trial for a possible treatment to help those infected by COVID-19. If you're 18 or older and have tested positive for COVID-19 during the past 5 days, you may be eligible to participate. There's a clinical trial located nearby, and participation is voluntary. You may stop at any time. Participants will receive study-related care at no cost. To learn more, visit MerckCovidResearch.com. That's MERCKCovidResearch.com.
You know I love cool gadgets. One of my favorites, the Ring Alarm System. It's a powerful, affordable home security system. So easy to install. You can do it yourself in no time. Have it up and running in minutes. But what I like about it, peace of mind protection. Check it out quickly and easily from the Ring app whenever you're away. Enjoy yourself. Don't worry. And if something's happening at home, Ring will let you know. And of course, the Ring Alarm is seamlessly with all your other Ring products in one simple app. I'll tell you what. You think you check your phone a lot. Wait till you get your first motion alert saying, hey, packages just stepped up stuff at your front door. You'll be hooked. Okay. No more pork bandits. For a special offer on Ring Alarm, go to ring.com/Leo to get your home anytime, anywhere with a Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/Leo for a special offer on a Ring Alarm security kit today. It's a system that's right for your home. Have it up and running in minutes. ring.com/Leo. Tell them Leo sent you. You've been lied to. Lied to by corrupt Washington politicians and the Wall Street propaganda machine. Hi, I'm Inc. Magazine best-selling author Brett Kitchen, and I want to give you a free copy of my brand new book, Wealth Beyond Wall Street, because we all know another market crash could be right around the corner. After losing 35% in my IRA in the crash years ago, I said enough, and since then I discovered a way to grow money potentially double digits, reduce taxes dramatically, and also have my money protected when the next stock market crash hits. When the next market crash hits, you lose nothing. Call Wealth Beyond Wall Street now to get your free copy and talk with a specialist to discover this little-known strategy to get potential double-digit growth during good years and never lose when the next stock market crash hits, all while building a tax-advantaged retirement. Call 800-908-1616 to discover this asset that people like Walt Disney and JCPenney use to grow wealth. Plus, for one of his 97 free books left, we even cover shipping and handling, no credit card required. Call 800-908-1616. That's 800-908-1616. 1-800-908-1616.
Live on AM 640. More stimulated talk. I'm a blue, blue man in a blue, blue house. If I were green, I would die. I'm blue.
Only earworms all day long, right?
Leo Laporte, T-Tech Guy, 8888-ASK. Leo, the phone number. Back to the phones. We go. Caller Jay from, oh boy. Now, you wrote, oh, and Jay hung up. So, there you go. Save me a little trouble there. Ken, because you wrote, worst texture in Mass. And I believe it's Worcester. Now, Jay would have confirmed this or not. Did he say Worcester? Did he say Worcester? Yeah, that's okay. I'm just wondering, did he say Worcester?
No, he said Worcester to me.
Yeah, but you wrote Worcester.
Well, I wrote
it. You wanted me to say Worcester?
I don't know how it's spelled.
Worcester. Maybe he was embarrassed by the pronunciation of Worcester. Worcester. Now, see, I know that because I grew up in Providence, Rhode Island, just down the road from Worcester. Newt, on the line from Aliso Viejo, California. Hey, Newt.
Hey, how are you, sir?
I'm good. Thanks for hanging on.
Oh, it's my pleasure, believe me. If you don't mind, I'd like to throw about three things up on the wall and you take your pick.
I'll answer them all if I can. I've got 8 minutes and 30 seconds.
Okay, sir, I'll be brief. Rural internet connections is interlinked our best hope going forward.
You mean Starlink, Elon Musk, satellite?
Yeah,
I think so.
So, this is a problem in this country because the way we've constructed this, it's all for-profit companies. And in fact, the for-profit companies have gone to state legislatures and said, no federally funded, no state funded internet for us. You got to use a commercial company. These for-profit companies like Comcast, Cox, AT&T, Verizon, it's expensive to wire up cities, so they're going to wire up places where there are the most people per square mile, because there's much potential to make money. You go out in the rural areas where there's one person for a couple of customers per square mile, there's just no incentive for them to spend thousands of dollars a foot to trench out there. So wireless providers are your best bet. Cell phone providers, they're putting up cell towers. They're still serving rural areas, not as well as urban, but better than the wired carriers. So cell phone providers might be one. Many rural areas, especially in Montana, Wyoming, big sky country, they'll use microwave systems. They're called wireless internet service providers, or WISP. You may have that option. But yes, I think ultimately, down the road, Starlink is going to be the best bet. Early users of Starlink are reporting a couple of hundred megabits very fast. Even though it's a satellite, the latency is relatively low, under 100 milliseconds. And not ideal maybe for a fast-paced video game, but certainly enough for most of the internet things you do. But right now it's expensive, $500 for the hardware, $99 a month for the access. But that price, I think, will go down. Elon's launching more satellites all the time. His goal is to get 12,000 up there. Last I saw, I think he wants to get more than 20,000 up there.
Oh, my God.
More satellites help because it means better connectivity. And his plan is to get internet access to every square inch of the globe. Not just the U.S., everywhere. So, I think that's the future. Have you signed up for it?
Yes, I did, but my concern is my friend who lives up a little bit north of you in Fort Plymouth, California.
So north, yeah, because at least over there, you can get your main sources. But up in Fort Plymouth, you may not, yeah. So north is good. Northerners are getting it sooner than others. I also signed up on the Northern California web as well. $100 to sign up, that's refundable if you don't do it. So you get in line. They still haven't offered it to me. I guess they haven't offered it to him yet either. The big issue right now is the cost. It is not the least expensive, but it's probably better. It's probably less expensive than the other satellite services like Wild Blue and Cheese and so forth. And I think it's going to be much, much better service. So.
I talked about this 3 years ago, and I think we were hoping that Starlink would come on sooner rather than later, but it's coming.
It's coming. Lots of people have it. Amazon's doing the same thing. They have something called Project Kuiper, K-U-I-P-E-R. They're going to have to change that name before they go public with it, I think. But they did get approval from the FCC to launch more than 3,000 satellites. So,
my granddaughter was not as concerned about rural internet connections 2 years ago. Now she's almost 12 and she's more and more interested. So,
she lives up in Fortuna. They really want to get online. And you know what? They need to. That's just
I've got a 27-inch iMac too. So, 2011 version. It's been working perfectly. But I've noticed that Apple seems to be backing away from the 27-inch.
No.
Should I buy a new 27-inch?
No. So here's what they're doing. They released, because they're doing, they're moving to Apple Silicon. They're making themselves just making their own. So the first iMac they released, in fact, the first MacBook and the first Mac Mini they released were all rolling. I think we're released earlier this year. Next month or the month after, they will announce higher-end processors with the higher-end machines. It's almost certain, of course no one knows for sure, because Apple doesn't say, but it's almost certain they will replace the 27 inches with 32 inches. They'll be roughly the same size, but smaller bezels, bigger screen. So if you like a big screen IMAX, you're definitely going to want to wait. There will be higher end IMAX, I think, this year. And they will feature the new processor. And all indications are that thing is going to be a beast. So if you want a higher end Mac, this is it. I would say wait, because it was a coming soon.
Well, that information is worth a dime I spent. Thing I wanted to say to you, sir, was about 2 or 3 months ago on that 27-inch iMac, that's been, I mean, it's as old as it is, it serviced well. When I would get up in the morning and turn that machine on, I started to get a question mark and a folder.
Ah, hard drive's starting to go.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, probably. The wagon is 10 years old. It's, the first thing to go is the thing with the moving parts. Yeah. If the chip survived the first year, they probably survive forever, except for the ultimate heat or moisture. But chips don't,
the parts are thinking there, okay.
I don't do. And that's not a difficult replacement. Some of them actually a little more complicated than others, but it might be worth it.
Big chairs, yes.
Okay, but I probably don't want to do it on the 2011.
If you've got put some money aside, put some pennies in that piggy bank, you're going to want to wait and see what Apple does in the next few months.
Well, I'll tell you what I did. I took those pennies and I bought eye drops.
Good man. Yeah, pennies a month, literally, yeah.
Yeah, exactly right. And the question mark in the folder is gone, and my computer is much faster.
Well, at least, and this is the nice thing, you guys.
Yeah, same.
That's really what's most important. And how does she, they're just lucky. They're moving parts. They will wear out. 10 years is a good long time for an hard drive to survive. So, yeah, a prudent thing would be to have a good backup. I think you did the right thing by getting an iDrive. In fact, Yeah, you got to protect your most valuable data, whether it's family photos, videos, important business documents. All you have to do is ask them if they've lost everything. They'll tell you from ransomware, for instance. They'll tell you, man, I wish I had backup. No reason not to. It's not a matter of if you're going to lose data. It's just a matter of when. With iDrive, you've got safe, secure cloud backup. And one account lets you back up everything you got. PCs, Macs, mobile devices, servers. It's easy to use. I should have asked there if you found it easy. It's easy to use, I think. Strong encryption means it's secure. PC Magazine's best backup solution again in 2021. Then that's 7 years in a row. $7 a month normally, but as you were saying, just pennies a month right now. Use my name Leo at iDrive.com, and that's for the whole first year. Well, if you need to back it up, you know it. Get iDrive. Use my name Leo.
Wow, man.
It's cool. Not to learn new language, but it will actually fit.
This is Kfi Am 640.
Kfi
AOS 2 HD2.
Los Angeles.